To start off, we're going to make some squares and some rectangles to put our oil pastel techniques in. So you're going to make 9 squares that are 2 inches by 2 inches, and then 3 rectangles that are 1 inch by 6 inches. What I like to do is mark along both sides half an inch, just to give a little bit of space, and then mark 2 inches, half an inch, 2 inches, half an inch, 2 inches, and then you can do the other measures down there. And then once I mark that on both sides, I'll go back over and connect those points just to make my lines nice and straight. If you have a way to do this that you find more efficient or that makes more sense to you, feel free to do that. But just make sure you have those 9 squares that are 2 by 2 inches, and then 3 rectangles at the bottom that are 1 inch by 6 inches. The first technique we're going to create is the light pressure blending. As a general rule with oil pastels, you want to start with the darker of the two shades. So here I've started with blue, and then I'll add some green. I'm going to move my pastel with light pressure and like little scribble lines filling in the space, starting more darkly at the edge of the square and then kind of fading it and overlapping. You want to make sure you're overlapping the two colors, and you can start by with one color and then move to the other. And then like you see here, I went back with the blue and I'm just kind of going back and evening that out. The next thing I'm going to do is heavy pressure blending. So I'm making similar lines, little squiggles like that, and pressing harder. So you can see I'm really filling in the paper. But then as I get towards the middle, I'm still going to lighten the pressure and let it kind of soften as it gets to the other side. Now I'll go back over with the green, and again, using those circular kind of scribbly motions, I'll fill it in at the edge and then kind of lighten things as they go towards the blue. And here with that lighter one, I'm going to start putting a little more pressure in, really trying to blend it into this blue-green color in the center. And I'll go back with a little bit of blue just to even things out, fill in all the space, the little gray spots that are there, and let those colors go together. For the heavy pressure, you may be tempted to blend it with your finger, but you can actually just use the pastels to do that. Now I'm going to try color mixing. So I put down 2 different layers of analogous colors with warm colors, yellow and then orange, and I put down a full layer with squiggly motions, and then I'm going to layer the other color on top. And I started with yellow on one side and orange on the other, just to see how that affects the final color when you layer them together. The next one I tried was cool color, so I did blue and violet. The one on the left, you can see I started with blue, and the one on the right, I started with violet, and you'll notice there's a little bit more of a difference between these two. Just like with our watercolors and colored pencils as well, we always get richer colors when we layer the different colors on top of each other. So here I'm doing a technique called scumbling, where I'm kind of moving in a squiggly motion. I started with green, and then I added yellow, and then I'm going to add a finishing touch of white. You can use lighter colors like yellow or white or light blue as a blending technique as well. So as I add this white to the top of here, it really will mix together those yellow and green colors that are underneath, and you get these really rich layers of color. Here I'm doing stippling, which we did with pencils and pens, but now we'll use the oil pastels, where you just add little marks. It takes a while, but you can add up the layers. To the right, I am doing a base layer. I'm blending it with my fingers to show you guys what that looks like, and then I use a paper towel right here. And then I'll do some stippling on top. So you can use that. You can add a base layer of color and then stippling on top. Our next technique is Sgraffito, and this is where you add 2 layers of pastel and then you scratch away to add some designs or some texture on there. So I added yellow and then green, and now I'm carving in a little leaf pattern. And you can do this with a paperclip or a butter knife or whatever works for you. There's many different things you can use. Next up is scratch art. So I first added a colorful background with colored pencils, and now I'm going over it with a black oil pastel, filling it in until I can't see any of the color, and then scratching away to reveal the rainbow underneath. Our final technique is transferring. So first I'm gonna start off by making a little doodle with pencil and a piece of white paper. And now I flip it over and I'm kind of looking through the paper and tracing that square. And I'm gonna add just a bunch of random colors and whatever pattern I want, filling that whole space in. And then I'll flip it back over again. And now I'm just gonna go over that design with my pencil to press that colorful background onto the paper. And then I'll reveal to you what happens. Here you can see my white pastel has some green on it, so I'll just wipe that off on a paper towel so when I move to my next color, it's ready to go. All right, it's time to come back to our blending. So I'm gonna use mostly heavier blending, but starting a little bit lighter. For the monochromatic value scale, you're gonna choose any color, start in the middle with the pure color, and then you can move to either side and add white to the right and black to the left. So here you can see I've kind of started working with my light blue pastel, and then I'll finish off with white. And then on the other side, I'm actually gonna start with black and then fade from dark to blue. And again, you can always start with the blue and move to white and then go back with that same blue and touch things up. So you'll see how I'll pick up my blue pastel again or the earlier pastel again and go back over it to smooth things out and to blend things together.
Fold your hand behind your ears, roll your questions across the floor. I know we've been here for years, but at least we've been here before.
Moving on to the warm color spectrum, I'm going to start with the darkest color, which is going to be this darker red, and then work all the way over to yellow, just from left to right. And you'll see, I'll be using the same technique of kind of lightening the pressure, and then overlapping those colors, and then adding some finishing touches at the end to really blend things together.
So long as I have breath in my lungs, long as there's a song to be sung, I will be yours and you will be mine. Ever our lives entwined, my roses shine, my roses shine. Like I said, I'm done, I'm yours forever.
Those those are our 9 techniques and 3 spectrums of color and value. So you guys are gonna be doing the same thing for your color choices. You have free choice for your colors, for the mixing, and for the blending. I would recommend using colors that are close to each other on the color wheel, but you have choice in what colors you use to complete these techniques.